Wow, all this month we've been daring to dream. We've heard all sorts of stories. We've learned about Langston Hughes. We learned about Robert Battles and what he went through to become a famous dancer. We learned last week about Trombone Shorty. And who remembers how they say hello in Treme? Yeah, that's how they said it there. Well, today, I want us to think a little bit. Have you ever heard these sayings about thinking outside the box? Or marching to the beat of a different drummer? Have you ever heard that saying before? You've heard of thinking out of the box? What do you think that means? Oh, it was a poster. You're not sure what it meant? Something that's outside of a box, that is correct. Who has an idea of what those mean? What do you think that means, Henry?
Thinking outside the box means it's a really good idea.
A really good idea that maybe somebody else had never thought of. Or it might be a little different. Well, today, we're going to be meeting Jean-Michel. And he does not color within the lines. In fact, he dreamed of being a famous artist. And his work, if you look at it, and I'm going to show you some, you might think it's not so neat and clean. Might look a little sloppy. Definitely coloring outside the lines. And actually a little weird, but so beautiful. So I want you to think outside the box. March to the beat of a different drummer and color outside the lines, all right? So, today my name is Jean-Michel. Nice to meet you. I was born in December of 1960 in Brooklyn. Now, in Brooklyn, I lived with my father, who came from Haiti, and his name was Gerard. And I lived with my mother, who came from Puerto Rico. Her name was Matilde. Now, my dad was kind of artistic, but not really. It was my mom who was the artistic one. She cooked and sewed and cleaned and designed our apartment, but the part I liked the best was that she would lay down on the floor with me and color and draw and take me to museums and show me everything in this city. And when people would come to my house, I wanted them to know that artists lived here, even from the youngest age. I had papers all over the floor and hanging from the walls and pencils everywhere, because when someone stepped into my house, I wanted them to know an artist lived here. My father loved jazz, so he would listen to jazz records very loudly while I drew. I drew all day long. Now, to me, art was not just something you saw. I did see art in everything. You know, the way the cars were lined up on the street, the way the buildings looked, the way the people all fit together, but I also heard art. I heard it in the way that people said words. So in a lot of my art, people call it graffiti art. In a lot of my art, you will see, you can pass that along now, you will see that I have lots of words in my art. Besides, because when I hear a word, to me, that means something. And when I was feeling sad and lonely, I would see that in my art. Now, when I was 7, I had a very bad car accident. And I was in the house for a very long time. But it didn't stop me from drawing my art. I just kept on and kept on and kept on. And when I was very sad, my art looked a little sad. But that was all right. Still not coloring within the lines. Still not very neat and clean. Kind of sloppy, kind of weird, but beautiful. So as I got a little bit older, I decided I should branch out and go to New York. So I went there, and to support myself, I did t-shirts, I did postcards, and I started to draw wherever I wanted to. Now, nowadays, we might say that we don't like that people draw all over mailboxes and walls and all of that because we call it graffiti. But it was very popular then. Wherever I could find a draw, I drew. And I drew under the name Simone. And everyone, I started to become famous because they saw my art everywhere. So in 1980, I had my first show in Times Square. And then in 1981, I had a huge show in Italy, and I sold my first artwork. So what I want you to think about today for my story is, just because it doesn't look the way everybody thinks it's supposed to look, or just because I don't say exactly what everybody else is saying, I want you all to think outside the box. March to the beat of a different drummer, if that's what you want to do. Color outside the lines, because guess what? God loves us no matter what. God loves us with all the rough edges. God loves us with the quirky things we say and do, and the way that we express ourselves. God will never leave, and God loves for us to color outside the lines. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for showing us these amazing four people who dared to dream. And each and every one of us here in the congregation today dare to dream something. Dare to dream something big, dare to dream something small, but we know, God, you will be there rooting us on, telling us, yes, you can. Amen.